There are a few things which you can do to Power BI using PowerShell, and those things are really an important thing and really helpful. So for example, you have a large data with a big data or BigQuery, and you are doing some ETL process and then bring it to your data panels. And it takes a lot of time to get and ingest the data and convert the transform the data. So you may not know the exact time when it's going to load complete data, and then your task is to refresh the Power BI dataset. In order to do that, you may not know the timing of it, so you're not able to set a scheduled refresh when it case of an import mode. In order to do that, there is a way by using PowerShell. Once this job complete, and then you can run this script so that it will refresh the data into Power BI service. We'll walk through the first phase of it in this video, and later on we'll upgrade to the next in-depth features of it. So let's dig into it. Hi, I'm Mohammed Adnan, and welcome to my channel, Tech18. Here in our channel, we discuss a lot about the Power BI, Power Apps, Power Automate, SQL, YouTube, and Excel, and a lot more to come in future. Not to forget, we have covered the basics of the Alteryx as well. If you're new to this channel, or if you're not yet a member of our channel, just hit the subscribe button to become a part of our family. Now let's get started. The first thing you need to do is to start and then click on PowerShell. So you need to run this PowerShell. I use this ISE, and it has to be run as an administrator mode. So once it is done, you need to do a few things. The first thing is you need to find the module dash name and then PowerShell get. And then you need to install this module of Microsoft Power BI Management. It will download it from the Microsoft and it will install onto your local machine. So once it is done, you need to type these two small scripts. One is login and Power BI. So once it is done, you need to select and then click on select. And then it will ask you for username and password. You need to select your email ID and then the password. I forgot to enter that. So once it is done, it will give you your environment, tenant ID, and the username. After that, you need to write this small script. There's a powerful thing. It is invoke dash Power BI REST API. So basically, it's just doing this REST APIs of Power BI into this. And here what I'm doing, the next phase is dash URL single quote dataset slash dataset ID and then refreshes and close the quote. Dash method post the body, and in the body you have to give the same dataset ID here. Now you might have get a doubt where I have got these informations, right? Give me a minute. Basically, if you go to this Microsoft.com APIs and Power BI dataset refresh, this is the one, and if you can see this one, the post http://v1.0myorg/datasets. So up to this stage, it will be taken care of by that script. And from here, we are adding those comments. As you can see, the dataset is there, slash, and then the ID of the dataset and slash refreshes. And as this post method, so I'm also adding the dataset ID in the body itself. Now let's run this one. Before running this one, let's have a look at the actual dataset. So this is the one I'm going to take this one. Now you might have wondered how I'm going to get the dataset ID, right? So for that also, you had to go to your workspace and you had to go to your dataset. And from there, more options and then settings. On the address bar, you can see the ID. This ID is your dataset ID. So I just copied and pasted the dataset ID over there. And if you can see, the timing is May 23rd, 11:02 PM. Now I'm going to run the script. I'm just selecting this now and this one. As you can see, the refresh starts immediately. The 11:02 is the timing, and once it is done, it will give the last refresh date and time. It will take time depends on the data set size and volume it has. So as you can see, it refreshed now. The time is 11:22 p.m. That's it. So just as a walkthrough, the first thing I did is find the module that named PowerShell get, and then install the module dash name Microsoft Power BI Management. These are the two things you need to do first time whenever you're going to run this script. Once it is done, you don't need to run all those again and again. And after that, you can just start from these steps. The first thing is you need to log into Power BI, and then you need to invoke the Power BI REST method and dash URL, the data set and its ID, and then the refresh method. And also you need to post, and in body, you have to pass the same data set ID inside to the body. Once it is done, you need to run this script. That's it. Now you can refresh the data set from PowerShell. So this is how you can able to refresh your Power BI dataset from PowerShell. This is an awesome, right? Even though this is a small thing, but this will be really helpful if you have situations like that, which I said before. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you're new to this channel, or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. But make sure you turn on the notification on your devices. If you're not a member of our channel, just hit the join button to know in detail about it. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you have any queries and feedback, just post it on the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.